يعني الله عز وجل عندما تحدث عن المسجد قال في بيوت أذن الله أن ترفع ويذكر فيها اسمه سبحان الله يعني the purpose of subhanAllah of us coming to the masjid is to get closer to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to purify ourselves so what is the benefit if we come to the masjid and then we become much more sinner and even worse than where we come subhanAllah because that's why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala called the masajid the houses of Allah a matter of honor in it tashreef min Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala so once you come to the masjid you have to behave you have to change That's why the masjid means what? A place of sujood. So when I come to the masjid, if the only thing that I do is making sujood, I do qiyam, I do read Quran, I do learn, but subhanAllah, the heart should be in a state of sujood. The heart should be in a state of sujood. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala soften our hearts. And may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala purify our hearts. And that is the very important thing that when Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said to Rabi'a ibn Ka'b radiallahu anhu, a young man, young sahabi, someone just wanted to get closer to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, so he was just following Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. In some narration he said, when I saw Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, said, I just wanted to serve Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. But he said, I was shy to ask him. Because he thought, I'm not worthy of asking Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam to be in his company. Look at the humility. Humility is the shortest way to get closer to Allah. He wanted to serve Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, but he said, I'm not worthy. How can I ask to be the servant of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam? How can I ask to be closer to Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam? And then he said, let me ask him, if he allows me, alhamdulillah. If not, at least I say I tried. He asked Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and what is the nature of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam? Other than making people happy, other than rahmah, as Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala described him, وَمَا أَرْسَلْنَاكَ إِلَّا رَحْمَةً لِلْعَالَمِينَ As they say our scholars, قَصْرُ مَوْصُوفٍ عَلَى صِفَةٍ يعني Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has limited the mission of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam only to be mercy sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Not to Muslims, not to humanists, but to all the world is lil alameen. So when Rabi'a approached Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, said, Ya Rasulullah, I want to serve you. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam knew that this is the very thing that will make him happy. So he gave it to him sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And this is very much consistent with Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He will never say no, except subhanAllah for something that is not allowed in the deen. But subhanAllah, even when the man said, Ya Rasulullah, give me your clothes, he gave him. When someone came and said, Ya Rasulullah, I need this, always he gives sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So Rabi'a said, Ya Rasulullah, will you allow me to serve you? He said, yes. So Rabi'a said, since then, I was following Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Wherever he goes, whatever he needs, I provide. And he said, to the extent that I was following Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, I could see what he needs even before saying it, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Jazakallah khair, fa'allah qadr. And one day he said, I was serving Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. I went home. I was about to sleep. Then he said, what if Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam needed something at night? It was not enough for him to be with Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam all the day, but also he said, what if he needed something at night? So he said, I came, and from his adab, he didn't knock the door to say, Ya Rasulullah, do you need anything? He just sat down at the doorstep of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He slept. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, when he opened the door, he saw this young man sleeping at his doorstep. He said, Ya Rabi'a, ma warak, what do you want? He said, Ya Rasulullah, I thought you might need something, so I just want to be here for you. And here we learn something much more greater from Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He has never took. He is the most worthy of serving. Whatever we do for Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, we didn't be able to pay him back. And serving him is a direct ibadah. But Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was not asking people to serve him. That's why in a hadith of Sayyidah Aisha, she said he was repairing his shoes. He was serving sallallahu alayhi wa sallam himself. He was serving himself. He did not ask people to serve him. So when he saw this young man, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said to him, Ya Rabi'a, if you need anything, I will give it to you. Ask me whatever you want. A very thoughtful, a very wise young man. He asked Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Ya Rasulullah, can I ask anything? He said, yes, you can ask. So Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is giving him, you can ask whatever you want. And he knows if Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam asks Allah anything for this young man, Allah will give him. So a wise man, he said, Ya Rasulullah, then amhilni, give me some time. He doesn't want to rush because he might say, Ya Rasulullah, I want this. And then he might remember something. So he said, let me prepare a list. He said, Ya Rasulullah, amhilni, because this is chance. And subhanAllah, even Ramadan is a great chance for us. So Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said to him, okay, he gave him a time. After some time, he came to Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, while Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was in the masjid. He was alone sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So when he saw him, he said, Ya Rabi'a, have you made your mind? He said, yes, Ya Rasulullah. So what do you want? He said, Ya Rasulullah, I want to be in your company in Jannah. I want to be in your company in Jannah. So Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said to him, have you asked anyone? He said, no. But he said, I thought about it. Whatever you give me, it has a time. It will go, it will disappear. So he wanted Jannah and he wanted to be in company of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam Jannah. So Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said to him, A'inni ala nafsika bi kathrati sujood. This is why I mentioned this hadith, because I mentioned this hadith before as well. And we will keep mentioning this hadith, especially for those of us that we are regular to the masjid. The regulars, they have to be imams and guides. So Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said to him, help me by making a lot of sujood. So if you want to be in the company of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in Jannah, you have to make a lot of sujood. What is this sujood that Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is speaking about? The sujood of the heart. Your heart to be in a state of humility. Instead of begging Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Let us look at Ibrahim alayhi salam and Ismail alayhi salam. Ibrahim, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave him a task that the whole ummah should do. Build the Kaaba. Build my house. No one was with him other than his son Ismail. And they built the Kaaba. After finishing that great job, what do they say? رَبَّنَا تَقَبَّلْ مِنَّا إِنَّا كَانْتُ. They beg Allah to accept it from them. The righteous ones, they don't see their effort. They see Allah's blessing upon them. Every tawfiq that we have is a ni'mah from Allah. We are not sitting in this masjid because we deserve it, because we are righteous ones. It is Allah's rahmah upon us. If it wasn't for Allah's rahmah, wallahi, we wouldn't be here. And coming to the masjid is wallahi a big ni'mah. And we've seen it. We are the generation of COVID for Allah's sake. There was a year we were not allowed to come to the masjid. We were not allowed to come to salah. Salat al-Jama'ah was not allowed. To come to the masjid was not allowed. Masajid were empty. Allah showed us that it is possible that the thing that we take for granted, Allah might take it away. So when Allah gave us the masajid, we have to behave. We have to appreciate this ni'mah that Allah has given us. One thing we forget is, when I am in a masjid, it doesn't mean that the masjid is going to wait for me, or Allah has given me a long life to come back to the masjid. It might be the last visit that I am giving to the masjid. So do I really want to be the last visit that I have in a masjid? That I was not pleased, I didn't have the adab, I didn't have the akhlaq, I was not appreciative of being in the masjid. For Allah's sake, the first thing that Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam did when Allah brought him to Medina was to build the masjid. And he was carrying sallallahu alayhi wa sallam himself the bricks to build that masjid. Masajid are ni'mah. is a sign of iman. But it is when we appreciate it. When we use our time wisely. When we use our time to read the Quran, to remember Allah, to spread khair. And then we will be rewarded. But subhanAllah, sometimes we might come to the masjid and we leave the masjid worse than where we come. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless you, my dear brothers and my dear sisters. Forgive me, I was to speak about something else, but I was brought into this subject. And it is very much repeatedly we speak about this ni'mah that Allah has given us. These masajid are ni'mah and a blessing of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And you cannot come to the house of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and you do not show Allah humility and taqwa. That's why Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, when you read Quran, either cry or even pretend at least to be crying. And that's why Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, إِنَّمَا الْحِلْمُ بِالتَّحَلُّمِ. Wisdom is a process. No one can tell me, I am angry, I cannot control myself. No, you can. You can. We have to have the patience. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forgive our sins. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala purify our hearts. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make us from those who honor the masajid of Allah. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make us appreciative of His blessing. Subhana rabbika izzati amma yasifun. Wa salamun ala al-mursaleen. Walhamdulillahi rabbil alameen.